Welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am giving demo of digital IC trainer. Its order code is 38621. Before starting the experimental procedure, I'll give you the brief description of this panel. This is the digital IC trainer and this is the BCD display. Here we'll give the input and here we can see the outputs. These are the pin connection for the IC base. These are the resistors and capacitors for the connections in the different circuits. This is the IC regulated power supply of 5 volts. This press switch is mono pulsar press switch. It is for providing the pulse for the different circuit. It is for the clock. From here we can give the clock of different frequency. These two are the potentiometers of 10K. These are the logic inputs and this is the logic level indicators to see the output. Coming on to the experimental procedure of digital IC trainer, firstly, I will show you how to perform the different logic gates on this trainer. For the purpose, I am taking the NAND gate IC, that is 7400 IC. Insert the IC in the IC base. Open this IC base, insert the IC like this. Cut is on the upper side. Now, as you know that in the NAND gate, 1 and 2 is for input and the third is for output. So I'm connecting first input, second pin. Second pin to the second input, third pin to the output. Now I am grounding the seventh pin as it falls to the ground, and for the power supply I am connecting the 14th pin. Now you can see that when the both of the input is 0, the output is high. When I am giving 1, 0, the output is high. When I am giving 0, 1, the output is high. But when I am giving 1, 1, the output is 0. So that's how you can perform the different logic gates on this IC trainer. Coming on to our next experiment, that is how to perform half adder using this IC trainer. Now for the purpose I am using two ICs, 7486 IC and 7408 IC. I am inserting 7486 IC in the first IC base and 7408 IC in the second IC base. Now the connection is according to the lab manual. I am doing the connections here. Connect the first pin of 7486 to the first logic input and connect the second input of 7486 to the second logic input, and connect the output of 7486 to the first logic indicator. And it will be our output for sum. Now connect the first input of 7486 to the first input of 7400 and connect the second input of 7486 to the second input of 7400. Now connect the output of 7400 to the second logic indicator and it will act as a carry. Now connect the power supply. For this, connect the 14 pin of both the IC and connect it to the power supply like this. Now connect the ground. For this, connect ground of both the ICs and connect them to ground. Now our connection is completed. For the truth table, you can go through the lab manual. Now I'm switching on the power. For 00, our sum and carry bit will be 0. For 01, our sum will be 1 and carry will be 0. For 10, our sum will be 1 and carry will be 0. And when both the inputs are 1, 1, our sum will be 0 and carry will be 1. This was all about the half adder. Similarly, you can perform the full adder, full subtractor and half subtractor. Coming on to our next experiment, that is how to perform flip-flop in this digital IC trainer. For the purpose, I am performing the clocked RS flip-flop using the IC7400. I am inserting this IC7400 in this IC base. Now, connection is according to the manual. Firstly connect the first pin of IC to the first logic input. Connect second pin and fourth pin and connect common of there to the clock pulse. Now connect the fifth pin to the second input. Now connect the pin third to the 12th pin. Always remember, if it is a 7-pin IC, we'll see the second row. Now, after connecting that, connect the sixth pin to the 10th pin and now connect the ninth pin to the 11th pin and connect the 11th pin with the output. It will be our Q output. And now connect the 13th pin to the 8th pin and it will be our Q bar output. Now connect the 14th pin to the power supply and connect the 7th pin to the ground. As our connections are complete, I am switching on the Now, from the lab manual, you can observe the truth table. If both the inputs are 0, there will be no change. I am giving the pulse and there is no change. Now, when the input is 10 and when I am giving the pulse, the output will be 10. You can see the output is 10. Now I am changing the input. If the input is 01, I am giving the clock pulse and the output is 01. Now at the end, when the both inputs are 1, it will be at intermediate state. So this was all about the flip-flops. Similarly, you can perform the other flip-flops on this digital IC trainer.